We're on now for the final. It's the 2017 Fanet Elite final between Craig Smithers and Andy Cross.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's nice to commentate on this evening's event. Hopefully, we'll see some decent pull.
Who are you fancying?
Well, which game are we looking at here then, John?
We're on Smithers. Smithers Crossy.
The Smithers and Crossy.
If we have to.
Yeah, it's all going on this evening. So we've got three major games playing tonight. Obviously, we were focusing on the Smithers and Crossy match. I don't know, John. I don't know. Obviously, Crossy over the years has been the major player.
He's a dominated force in the league, really, isn't he?
He has been a dominated force. But on the other hand, Kirby last year could have took him. Kirby only played a silly shot, one silly shot, costing the match, the whole match.
I didn't see it myself, but I did hear about it.
Yeah.
He's been playing quite well. He played really well against Lucas, 9-3. And Lucas put me out, and Lucas played really well.
Who, Kirby?
Lucas.
Oh, Lucas. Yeah, once again, a nice quality. Here we go. So the arm wave with Craig there to start off with, so... He gets frustrated so quick, doesn't he?
Yeah, I do think if Andy gets two or three in front, he'll start screaming a bit. You know, it'll get to him. It normally does.
Yeah, Crossy is 100% focused. He's always has been. He has been the number one of Planet Thanet throughout my pool career, to be fair. Who's that then, John?
I'm up and coming.
Yeah. Well, you are quality, mate. You are quality. But anyway, let's just focus on their game and not yours.
Next year, Pete, next year. Andy's chosen yellows.
Yeah.
I think it's the right choice. He's got that red locked up anyway, hasn't he? I can't see him getting a shot here, to be honest.
I think he looks quite focused, actually, doesn't he?
Well, this should be just a easy, relatively easy runner.
I think you're going to be right here, though, John, because like once Andy gets a good substantial lead, then he's going to fall to part. He's going to fall to bits, Craig.
The thing is, like, if Craig can read off a few frames, Andy will start to feel the pressure himself. But it's just whether he does or not. Obviously, you've got Crossy's major favourite. You know, at the end of the day, he's won it every year he's been on.
Yeah, he has, yeah. Well, like what I say, he is number one of Planet Thanet. He always has been. And hopefully that, well, someone will take over.
I mean, he's basically the Cristiano Ronaldo of Thanet Pool. Love him or hate him, he still pulls out.
Yeah, and do you know what? He looks like Ronaldo, doesn't he?
Don't know, he looks like he only had a wash in about a week, though. Do him a shave.
Yeah, I thought that he was Portuguese.
I thought he'd been fucking dragged through the mud before he got here.
At least he's got his T-shirt on, John.
They do say the camera adds £10. Obviously, they must have a couple of cameras on him at least.
Yeah.
I think that's 1-0 Stratton. Is that 1-0 Stratton? Yeah, in the plate final, it's 1-0 Carl Stratton.
Yeah.
What's that, first to seven? First to eight.
Well, I think he's left himself a bit straight on this ball, and whether he can pop that one over the top left hand corner.
I think this is a little bit of Hollywood. This, I think, it just goes quite clearly.
I don't know. He's taking his time. It's got to be the longest shot so far.
Yeah. But The final is on the shot clock, 60 second shot clock.
Is there a time limit on each shot then, John?
For 60 seconds.
Oh, they are playing the minute rule then?
To be honest, that was a relatively easy shot.
Well, it was, yeah. I couldn't understand why he was taking so long, actually. I didn't think that he could see that ball, to be fair. Well, it's only perfect, and that's it. Well, thanks ever so much. Was that off the break, John?
No, that was Smithers' break.
So it's one shot pull, isn't it?
Yeah, that's why it should be, though.
Well, yeah.
They don't call it a Thanet two shots, they call it a Thanet elite, don't they?
Well, yeah, but it's getting to the stage now with this game that, and these new rules that we play now, it is one shot pull.
Yeah.
If you don't pop from the break, to be fair, I think you're going to say that you're fucked.
Well, you say the old rules, there is no. You say the new rules, there is no old rules. Those rules don't exist anymore.
Exactly. No, you're
still
exactly
playing
right.
Those rules out there. You're out of date. Yeah. You're actually not playing elite.
That's
game.
Right. And and being that Thanet has always been BAPTO rules, you've got to keep up with BAPTO rules. Because what you're doing is you're stopping the young players playing the right rules.
Yeah,
you know.
At the end of the day, the people that still play the old rules, they play them because they can't play these new rules.
Mm.
They're not.
Yeah. I'd just like to say that someone else has just come into the commentator's office. It's young Nettie Cross. Which we won the mixed doubles. When do we win the mixed doubles then, Nettie?
Shameless brag.
I can't even fucking remember.
Well, there's no need for that. I thought that it had been like tattooed on her forehead. But anyway.
What mug? Smithers has taken red.
If that helps.
Mine's in some other person's loft, no doubt. But anyway.
It's still there.
But anyway, nice to see you, Nettie.
I'll go back to my seat now.
Smithers taking reds. Obviously, Andy broke. It was a dry break. So at the moment, people's brakes not working to start off with. This thing is a weird one. Especially the back cushion seems to ping. You watch
but he's taking reds. He's got his work cut out on this clearance.
That was unlucky. He might have a good angle here, though.
Yeah, but he's got a problem with that red on the top right hand side, isn't he?
Yeah, but he's got a chance of moving it here. Is he going to roll through enough? Well, he left the unless he can pop the one into the middle, left to play the one into the top left hand pocket. He can obviously get through to it. That's a result. This would be a good shot. Do you reckon he'll play to move it here? Off the stun it into the middle.
Yeah, see, I don't think that he's got the position to do that. And the black is the black is out in the open now. He might be able to do is take the long one down into the bottom pocket, and then that red might come off the yellow. But obviously, he might not take that shot because he hasn't seen it.
Well, you said it loud enough, he might be able to hear it, mate.
Oh, sorry about that. Sorry about that, John.
It was a double. If that bounces enough, he was lucky there. If that bounces out more than probably another half a ball, then it's 3-0. It should be 2-0.
Yeah, well, I think that Andy might pop this one over the top right and then play a snooker. I think that's what he'd be looking at.
You can hear Craig already. He's just starting to get a little bit wild. He needs to compose himself. It's only the first frame. It's a long match.
That's right. Yeah.
I don't know if Andy's got the angle to move it here off the top cushion.
Yeah, he's playing very. He's very attacking, isn't he?
Bit left hand top. He should just move this off the side cushion. He'll stay on the red to the corner pocket. It's a good shot.
Yeah, that's a lovely shot, isn't it?
I'll have to teach you that shot one day, Pete.
The only thing you'd be able to teach me is how to fart, John.
We can have a catch game if you want.
Oh, I'll have to go into training first.
Yeah, you have to go to the bank manager as well. This is in all realisticness, this is 2-0. He's not missing from here. He shouldn't miss from here.
No, I wouldn't have thought. He's got it.
Move this again off the route.
I think he'll come up near the middle bag. Oh, well, look at that.
Wow.
Well, there you have it.
Can you believe he missed that?
No.
That is a big miss. In the context of this match,
that's right. 2-0. That was a big shot that he missed there. Well, what's going on?
Especially with Craig, obviously, starting to feel the pressure straight away, moaning about things. You can hear him. He's a little bit
negative.
Well, I mean, he's just a little bit pent up, isn't he?
I mean, maybe, you know, there is a lot of psychological parts of this game, but at the end of the day, the way Craig is that he beats himself up, and once you beat yourself up, then you're fucked, didn't you?
He shouldn't have missed that bit, though. Come on, mate. I mean,
No. He got given a present.
And this shot here could bring it all back out into the open. Oh, my God.
Well.
If this isn't 1-0, he might as well unscrew his cue and go home. He might as well, because you have to make these chances count. I mean, you're not going to get a player around.
He's got to start composing himself, or else, if he don't win this now, as you say.
He's played a good...
God, it's running a bit slow, isn't it?
Well, he's got lucky there. I don't know why he didn't just play it on and off the cushion, roll it in and then roll the black in. I mean, it's easy for us to say sitting here, but obviously when there's thousands of people watching...
What, the red into the top pocket, the same as the black? Is that what you meant?
Yeah.
It's not a bad shout. Oh, he's gone for a timeout. Well, it's all interesting now.
Must be. It's Tommy. We're joined by the great James Bradford. Grim Jim, AK.
Oh, see now, this is not a sitter. Why? I missed that shot, John, but how the hell did... He got lucky. I think that he got lucky on that game. That's brought him back to life. Now Andy Cross is now going to feel the pressure because he knows that he had two chances, major chances, and he blew it in that game.
To be fair, that frame, if they was asked, they'd both want him taken off the video. They weren't a great one to watch.
Yeah.
They both missed chances. Craig almost missed a third chance to win the frame. You're not going to get that many chances against Andy to win frames.
Yeah.
You've got to take the first time, second time maximum. You cannot be having three chances.
Well, no.
They're almost mucking it up. But at the end of the day, he didn't muck up his third chance. This 1-0, wasn't it?
Well, it blew my words right out of the water when I say it was one shot pull, and then suddenly you've got misses there.
This frame is going to be a little bit different. Mm. There is a pot off the break.
That's a bit like one of my breaks,
it's
John.
It's one of each, but to be honest, I think this is going to be a bit of a tactical frame.
Well, it'd be nice to see actually, because we know that both of them are capable of clearing. But are both of them capable of having their B games? And that is putting balls over the hole. Or is he going to go for a development? No, he's just gone for a straight shot. I thought he might try to screw back there and try to develop that ball.
It's two easy balls, really. That's Andy telling us his life story already. Thanks for that, Andy. You know, the worst thing is we're watching it and then you're telling us about it. Cheers, mate.
It's nice that Andy Cross is joining in and still playing the final. So you know that he's not stressed out whatsoever. You won't see Craig Smithers do that at all.
I can't believe he's trying to take this out here. This is definitely a tactical sort of thing.
It is a tactical game. Yeah, see, now he ruined that because he could have developed that ball He could develop them balls earlier on in that clearance, but he refused it, and then what he's done is he's played a massive shot, and it's all turned out bandy. Well, unfortunately for Craig, then that was the total wrong shot.
I mean, everybody knows me to be a tactical player, for me to be an attacking player, and even I could see that balls needed to be put over the hole. That it wasn't one of those you're going to dish in one frame.
Exactly. No.
I just think in that instance that was the wrong sort of shot to play.
Yeah, I reckon it was, because even if he'd have hit that and the black would have gone over the hole or gone over on the right hand side of the table, all his reds was over there anyway, so he's going to hamper him anyway. So what's the point of playing the shot?
Meanwhile, just to interrupt you, there's 1-0 Carlton in the cup match against Jamie Disney.
Oh, yeah, Mark Cofer's up. Well done.
That's another try break. Have we seen a ball? Oh, no, we saw the ball potted in the last frame. Cofer and Disney's 1-0 to Mark Cofer, and Jamie Disney's just going off the break. So he's got two shots with the ball in hand. So
back on the main table, we've got now Craig Smithers to try to take his shot. I think that he will take yellows here, don't you think, John? Or this should be quite an easy clearance for Craig. Apart from obviously the black, he's got to develop the black, but he must be able to do that when he takes the plant in the right-hand top corner. He's missed it. He's missed another sitter.
I actually think the pressure's getting to him both a bit. Obviously it's a big occasion.
Well, yeah, John, but... I don't know, mate. Yeah, I'm quite stunned by it, to be fair.
I cannot believe he missed that yellow.
No.
It's not like, I mean, you can say what you want, but it's not like he's not getting enough chances to win the frame.
No, not at all.
I still can't get over it, it's my hopes.
You know, Craig have been easily 2-1 up.
Yeah, both had your chances, didn't you? Both had your chances. The main thing is you're still getting the chance, isn't it? No.
Oh, it's quite unfortunate there, actually. He played the shot.
I think he played to try and split the red and black, but it looked like he tried to make it look like he was going for the one to take off the
court. Well, that one, hopefully after the match, then we'll be able to talk to him about that shot and wonder what he was playing.
He won't remember. He don't even remember it to brush his teeth. Andy realises that this is a tactical play on this frame.
So he's made that choice, and that's what he's done now. See, instead of what like Craig did in the last game.
I think Craig's had his hair cut.
Yeah, I think he has.
That always had his ears lowered.
Yeah. I think he's lost weight as well, and he...
Yeah, he dropped his wallet on the way in.
Oh, did he? Mind you, he's... he works up decks.
What are you doing? In this frame, what are you doing?
What am I doing on this game? Well, he's got to start playing a bit tactical. He can't go for the clearance. He cannot. He cannot do any massive shot. Now, I wouldn't have called that shot. Now, that was a pretty good shot, actually, wasn't it?
Yeah, to be honest. But Andy's just going to move this one straight out and move the black away as well.
Well, I think that Andy will leave the black where it is.
Actually, yeah. I don't think he's got the angle to, but I don't think he'll want to do that shot, actually, anyway. Thinking about it, I think
he'll just put this over the arm.
Yeah, he'll just lock this ball up, would he? Lock the pocket up.
He's just said that it's not touching the cushion. So that means that the yellow is the only ball that needs to touch the cush, but anyway, the red touched it anyway.
I don't know if he's played that shot too well. I think that still passes.
Yeah, he played it a bit too hard, didn't he? But at the end of the day, it still puts Craig in a...
I'll tell you what, I think Craig's got a chance to take this out. If that red part, if that yellow passes a red...
Yeah, but he's...
Just depends. He might play just a stun shot just to take it away from the red.
See, at this moment in time, I don't think Craig wants to... He's not 100% positive in what he's playing because of the last game. So, obviously, he's going to hold back because some of the shots that he's missing is not that good, but... See now, Andy might move this red over to the left-hand side of the table. Move the red from the yellow. No, he's decided not to.
We could be in for a few more frames like this as well, to be honest.
Yeah, it started really quick. I just cannot understand why he would pop that ball.
The thing is, I mean, obviously, he's got that pocket on lockdown at the moment. So I don't disagree with him trying to move the black out there. But it's a big target. He should be hitting that.
I think it was a bit of a premature shot, to be fair, you know. But now he's developed that ball out. So now, if you know, once you've got your balls into position, then you can start thinking about developing the black.
I'm not sure if Andy can see this shot into the top corner. From our commentary box, it doesn't look like he can. You never can tell with the angle.
Whether he's looking at a deep screw shot here. No, he's just a tap shot. It hit that ball. It was a very fine shot.
Do you not think Craig's got a chance here to try and take it out?
Once again, I don't think that he's in that sort of frame of mind at this moment in time.
I think,
you know,
if you're trying to play this into the top pocket or into the middle, but either way, I think he might have a go here. He's only got to get one decent angle to move the black out, and then all these balls are there. I do think he's going to try and take this out. He might even try and move the black here if he's got the angle.
Pop the one in the middle and then come around two cushions and to develop the black? Or
I think he's got the angle to do that. And if he catches it full ball, then he'll land.
Yeah, it's a possibility that he can just pop this one and come off two cushions and develop the black.
If he hits the cushion first and hits the red, then he'll still be on the yellow. Just like that,
yeah,
brilliant shot.
Lovely shot. Yeah.
That could win in the frame. The thing is with Craig, he looks unhappy with that shot, but I think it's fine now.
Yeah, well, obviously now that where the black is, he's got to take the black down the rail into the bottom pocket.
Well, I mean, the way he just shaped up there, I think he's going to try and leave himself a double.
See, now, I wouldn't have took that ball first. I would have took the one in the middle bag first and then see if I can get onto the other one and leave that one as an insurance.
He's now got to try and drop this in dead weight to remain on the red, the yellow into the top pocket.
This is going to be a difficult shot here.
That's a good shot.
Yeah, that was a good shot. He played that well.
He's definitely leaving. He shaped up for the double earlier, so he's definitely leaving himself.
Yeah, yeah. Now he's leaving the cross double, I think, there. That was...
It's queuing down though.
Oh, he did, Andy. He did go for the long black.
No, he didn't queue that up for long, did he? Before he went for that.
No. Now, cost double all the way, wouldn't it?
Well, I mean, I agree with both shots, but at least take your time on the shot. You seem to, I mean, I'm the fast player, but you seem to get down and just hit that straight away.
Yeah, but it was a big shot because it, but he didn't even get on the blank, so, you know.
Does it pass down the rail?
Yeah, I reckon it passes. And even if it don't pass, it go over the hole. This looks like it's going to be 3-1.
Do you not think he might even try and move it? He's got the angle to move it if he wants to in the black. Just as the same shot as earlier, a little bit of top, right, left hand side, just come off the top.
If it passes that one down, if it passes that yellow down the bottom, then there's no need. But he has developed it. Nice call, John, nice call.
I don't see the value in not trying to move it there. If it
no.
It obviously didn't pass the yellow.
It just goes to show how rusty my game is, because I really did not see that shot. It's nice actually commentating with you actually, John, because basically I'm seeing shots that I should really see.
And it's going to be 3-1 Andy.
Yeah.
It was a good shot to develop the black, but yeah, as I say, that shot, I think that shot was always on.
Yeah, 100% right.
And this could be bad news for Craig.
Yeah.
If he goes 4-1 down, I can't see him coming back.
No,
that's
3-1.
That's 3-1 Andy. It's 1-1 Mark Colfer and Jamie Disney in the cup final, and it's also 3-1 to Cole Stratton against Ian Garrett in the play.
Cole Stratton was playing well earlier in practice, and
I mean, obviously I play a lot of pool with Cole, and he's very capable. The other day he run 4 dishes in a row against him. He's a very capable player.
Yeah, he is playing a lot lately though, isn't he? He's on the pool table quite a bit, so the practice is. The practice level is pretty high. Whose beer was that then?
Once again, Andy giving us his fucking life story.
I can't believe you've got a referee that comes in and racks the table and then puts his beer on the bloody table. What's all that about?
Will we see a ball potted off the break this time? Yeah, well, there's a ball down. Looks like a yellow ball down, I think. Yeah, yellow ball down, but to me, it's red. I can't see Craig getting a shot here. All the reds go everywhere.
Yeah.
The only thing I can see is if that black doesn't pass the yellow into the corner, right hand corner pocket.
Yeah.
But if that's not the case, it'll black up into the top left or into the middle. So I think this could be 4-1. Where's that cue ball going? Where's that cue ball going?
Oh. Who's that, John? It's John Virgo.
It's Virgo. Jimmy White scores 5.
I like a little bit of John Virgo.
He's a good commentator. Yeah.
I fucking hate Willie Thorne.
Negative, isn't he?
Oh, so much. They called him Mr. 147 and he never saw him do a 147.
He made a 1-4 and a 7.
Yeah.
Good shot by Andy there. Nice little nudge.
But there again, in them days, the cloth had more hair than him, didn't it, really?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think I'd have been a top professional in those days. The odd 100 here and there, people were fucking jumping with joy, aren't they?
Yeah, that's right. Well, so he's back up the table. Is he going to drop this one in?
I mean, I know I'm shouting it. I know I shouted it already, but I still think this is a breaking dish. and he's got one hard shot to play, one relatively hard ball. That's it. He'll play this ball up the table for the red.
Yeah, because the red does pass into the... Oh, wow. He's missed that one.
Well, he hasn't just missed it. He missed that by a long way.
Yeah. Yeah, I was talking earlier about one shot pull, but I suppose one shot pull is only in practice, because when it comes to a match, it's a lot more difficult. There's a lot more tension in the arm. There's people that.
That's why we play, though, really, isn't it? That's why we play.
Yeah.
For that tension on the thrill of it.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. It does keep you active. It keeps the mind active.
So what's Craig doing here then? So is he just going to move it down into the bottom pocket? Looks like he's playing a safety. It's a bit hard, is it?
It's not too bad. It's not too bad.
Yeah, it doesn't pass.
It doesn't go down the bottom, does it? No.
It's a good shot. He hasn't left him a pot. No. It's just what Andy can do. He might try and lock up one of the pockets, but I don't even see him being able to do that, really.
See, sometimes it's better to let the opponent see their ball, because obviously he's got to make contact with the cushion.
Just stunning that red to hit the yellow onto the side.
And come beyond these two balls at the bottom. Is he looking at that? I think he is. Oh, no, he missed that shot. But I think that's what he was playing for.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. If you've just tuned in, which you'd have to be some sort of cunt to tune in, because this is on YouTube, so this is a played video. So you must have watched it from the start. But if you have just tuned in, it's currently... 3-1 Andy Cross and Craig Smevers in the 2017 Thanet Elite final. If you're interested in the cup matches, Mark Colfer's 2-1 up on Jamie Disney, and Ian Garrett's just pulled one back against Carl Stratton. It's now 3-2 in the plate. So they're all pretty close matches, apart from this one that we're watching here at the moment. But the scoreline doesn't really reflect how they're both playing. They're both missing chances. Is he just going to try and lock this pocket up? I don't think he wanted that to go in.
Maybe not. Whether that red now passes the yellow down the bottom right hand side.
I don't think it does. But he can either play. He's got the angle here.
But the position of reds at this moment in time are not good anyway.
He'd only have to leave that half ball. It depends if this one passes.
He could try to screw this one in the middle and then come between the two reds at the bottom of the table, and then he'd have a choice of red. But yes,
it depends if he wants to try and take it out there. To be honest, whilst he's got the chance, if that red does pass the top right hand,
I think he's in one of those situations where he's in a no. Whatever
Do you
he
think
does,
he's playing
yeah.
to pot this or just leave it over the pocket.
I think he's playing to pot this. It all depends, John. If that red passes that yellow, down the bottom.
To be honest, from the angle of win, I think it does pass. But I think he's going to lock up the bottom.
Well, this is a big shot, either way.
Down hard on it, so I don't think it is. Yeah, so obviously that goes. So he's going to play this off of two cushions. Three, maybe four cushions. Go around the angles and leave the red into the top left-hand pocket.
Yeah. Or he's going to play it off the two cushions to develop the red. So it'd be interesting on what shot he plays here.
I think developing the red, you're leaving it too much to luck. With the shot that I said, he's guaranteed to be on the red. I'd be playing this with... It looks like he's trying to move it. He looks like he's trying to move it or play it with a lot of left-hand side. Yeah, he plays it.
Yeah, he's got a nice shot.
I think that's much more of a gamble than going round off a
four-cushion. Yeah, it is more of a gamble, but it's this old style of play against the young person's style of play, you know. The attacking format would be coming off the two cushions to develop it or to just get on it. Where with Andy, it's dot-to-dot positioning.
Yeah, but I mean, if it was dot-to-dot positioning, surely he'd have played the shot that I said.
Yeah, but there's players out there that play off two cushions and some players that only play off one cushion. It's one of these choices again, isn't it? I mean, I am a two-cushion person myself, but... I think
it's just horses for courses, but yeah. Anyway, back at the ranch, this is going to be 4-1 Andy.
Yeah, and you can't take it away from him. That was a steady clearance. If he gets this...
Has he missed it?
He's missed it. He's missed the blank. He's missed a few shots.
That is massive.
It is a massive shot.
To go one behind or three behind is massive.
But there again, see now Craig. Yeah, well, Craig has missed some shots this evening as well. So it's quite tense out there.
I can't. The only tough ball is the black, and I can't see him missing that.
And what is he going to do with that black?
In the concept of this match, that is a massive, massive miss. And to be honest,
we've got now Joe Cunningham that's come into the old commentary box here.
It was a bit of a twitch from Mr. Cross, wasn't it?
Yeah, a little bit.
It was
a
bit of a twitch.
I mean, 4-1 is massive.
Yeah, and how well he done to get onto that black to, you know, from where the balls were. It will be a big one.
Oh, is he going to develop the black here?
Well, he's a bit too straight now, isn't he?
No,
he's a bit too straight?
Definitely,
yeah, but he might be able to develop the black, but he might not be able to get on this yellow.
Well, yellow's an open play. He's definitely playing to move the black.
That's a good shot.
Yeah, but he's come out well on that yellow as well, hasn't he? So it was a good shot.
You are not wrong when you said you're very rusty.
Yeah, I am. I am very rusty.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pete is still my hero.
He's not happy with that shot.
So and I don't know why.
You should just be getting down and potting this, not showing the emotion.
Yeah, that's just what I was about to say.
Potting it, then fist pumping.
Now, where's the cue ball going, Willie?
It's okay.
Oh,
where's that cue ball going?
It wasn't in the pocket, John.
Oh, bit of emotion by Craig there, just hitting the table, charging himself up.
Should have been 4-1. 3-2.
Yes, that should have been a three-frame advantage.
Yeah, I must admit that I haven't seen Andy miss so many shots as what I've seen tonight.
To be honest, he missed quite a few against me. He did miss quite a few against me. But he's a bit like Ronnie. He says that he doesn't practice that much. But to be fair, I haven't seen him down here that much, to be fair, so... In the meantime, that is now 3-1 Colfer, and Carl Stratton's moved another frame in front and taken it to 4-2 in the plane.
Yeah, I don't think Ian Garrett has led in that match.
No, he hasn't. To be fair, though, I mean, he's a bit of a winner.
Did Colfer win that last match?
No, Colfer won that last frame.
Oh, yeah. So he's 3-1 up now, is he?
Yeah, it's 3-1.
Yeah. So we're back on the main table, and Andy Cross now is 3-2.
Who broke first? Craig. This was off Andy's break, and I tell you what, this is a clearance. You show me a hard ball on this table, I'll show you how to put it.
Just to interrupt the state of play here, could somebody tell Mr. Cross it's his round as he has all the money?
Well, there's a bit of an issue there because obviously he's playing his match, but being the accountant as he is, you won't see that money.
Well, Craig hasn't played a good shot there. He's now got to try and avoid the knuckles on the right hand pocket. he's digging down. This could be a miscue. Yes,
oh, sir. See now that was a get down and a smash shot, because he didn't stay down on that shot whatsoever.
No, he's up. Yeah. Well, it's the second time. I mean, I'm quick, and even I know this.
That was a very quick shot that Crowe played there.
And he's playing to try and lock up the pocket.
See now, here we have it.
On a different note, I'm going for a shit. I'll be back in a bit.
Well, you can't leave me alone. You'll have to get Wendy over here.
Fuck Wendy. You want to sit next to Wendy?
No, I was just joking.
Oh, I didn't think you did. I can shit myself here. It's still better.
I don't know who to have over here. Either it'd be Adrian Luckhurst or Wendy Tyler. But anyway, while John's gone for a shit, I'm the only one in the commentary box, which... So my shot selection will be not as good as John's. But now we've got Nettie here as well. She's approached the commentary box, and now she's going to get a mic of her own, and she'll be on here. The ex-mixed doubles champion of a Wednesday night.
Thank you, Peter.
How you doing?
Retirement, that was.
Oh, have you retired now?
I've done blank since then.
Oh, haven't you really? Oh, oh, that's a shame, isn't it?
I wouldn't know what an end... Well, actually, I'll probably tell what end of the pool cue is, but how to play with it is probably another matter.
Oh, right, okay. Well, that's... have you got batteries in it, Nettie? But anyway, on a serious... I thought you had a pool table at home.
No, we got rid of that years ago.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, we don't have time to play anymore. If he does practice, then it's down here now.
Yeah, yeah. Same as always, isn't it? Work gets in the way of fun, doesn't it?
It's life itself, I think.
Yeah, it certainly is. Yeah.
Especially when it comes to your kids.
Well, your kids are grown up now, aren't they?
Bradley leaves school this year. It's a very important year. We had to have parents' evening last night. He's doing right. so well, so that's quite a priority at the minute, really.
Okay. Well, back onto the pool table. Well, this is going to be a big game for Andy, I think. He's going to start closing it down a bit, I think.
I think so.
You know, I think because Andy's B game is just as good as his A, and... to tighten up a game and tighten up a table. Where
when he makes one bad shot, that's it. That's where he starts tightening in it up.
Well, and he's made a few, but you know, he was a bit unfortunate. But
young John is back, so
oh, he is. Yeah. Well, that was a quick shit, John.
Well, that was pretty quick. I'd just like to say that got spat out quicker than a ham sandwich at a vegan party.
Do you know what, John? I've never been to a vegan party. What's it like?
They don't have ham sandwiches.
Yeah.
And if they did, it would come out quicker than that.
I bet they smoke herbs, not eat them. Oh, we got a bit of a... Craig's doing a bit of... Or doing a bit of Irish dancing, one of the two.
I think he's practiced it.
I just like to say you did have that mic.
Oh, that's thank God for that.
Yeah. Sorry, so if you missed my comment about the ham sandwich and my shit being very
quick.
Well,
is mine off?
No,
it
yours is on
there
constantly.
How do you know?
Because there is no one. But I was actually saying, now the mic's on, that my shit
so
came out quicker.
So you switched
it
your
got
mic
spat out quicker.
You switched your mic off so Nettie could not talk, have her personal views. Well, fair enough, John.
Anyway, before you
so selfish.
Me, we talking about my shit.
Bit like his
and
kebab,
how,
where he don't let, you don't share it.
And the reason it was quick is because it got spat out quicker than a ham sandwich at a vegan party. I didn't want that missed because it's a very funny joke.
Not funny to a vegan.
Fuck them. They don't deserve it anyway.
Well. We've got Andy now
in control.
Yeah, definitely he's in control. Whether he will try to attack again, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure whether he'll do an attacking shot here or whether he'll develop another ball. Yeah, see.
So, as we've got his misses here, what happens if he wins this tonight? Is it special?
It's special.
Special privileges.
Oh, special privileges.
What do you mean? Okay. He gets the other side of the bed.
Yeah.
No. He don't have to do the washing up, Pete.
I'd do that anyway.
You
might get the cold dad.
Well, surely he's onto a winner though.
Nettie, do
you
still take your teeth out when you do a blowjob?
You cheeky fucker.
To be honest though, he must be onto a winner, because even if he loses, she's got to try and console him a bit, isn't she?
That's it, exactly. He wins either way.
Yeah, well, that's right. Yeah, well.
And if you have an argument to fuck off, he can just get a kebab, can't he?
Yeah.
Just like to shout out to
the man should have some respect for what he's achieved, and I think that's not a bad shot there, John. I think that he's got it.
I think you find it's not a bad shot, it's a very good shot. But as I was saying, I just want to have a little shout out to the local kebab shop where I got my kebab from earlier, just in case they want to give me a free one. It was Bodrum, the best chips around.
Where's that then, John?
Bottom of the High Street, opposite the Arbor Bar.
Oh, right, Harbour Street, not High Street.
No, opposite
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, it could be.
Yeah, Harbour Street, not High Street, yeah. Get it right, John.
Sorry, mate. I can't help, he's getting a bit aggressive in his old age.
Anyway. Well, no, because I do like that place as well, actually, the bottom of the Harbour Street.
They do the halloumi.
Lovely shot.
Run inside, that's a good shot. And with that shot, he's definitely going to take it to 4-2.
Just ventured into the room is Richard Cook, one of the oldest members of Planet Thanet. He must be about 135 now, and he does a bit of plastering.
He's only 2 years behind you now, Pete, isn't he?
Well, yeah, I am getting on a bit now, John. Yeah.
Sorry, did you say going on?
Now he didn't hit centre of the pocket there. He did not hit centre of the pocket, which is threw that off.
I don't mug him off in front of his missus, but that was a stinker.
Yeah, but he didn't hit the middle of the pocket. He hit the middle of the pocket, he would have been bang on that. But once again, maybe a little pressure setting in from Andy. You know, can he be this number one player of Planet Thanet much longer? Because he has been the number one. No matter what you say, John, he might not be the best disher or, because you have got some quality youngsters coming through. And one of them is not you, because you're not young.
But at least you didn't say I wasn't quality.
But the fact remains is you have got some quality players. And can he keep on being this number one player?
I just want to interrupt you. Why is Craig shaking his head there? He's got an easy cut back.
Because he does believe that Andy got lucky, which maybe he got a lucky kiss, but at the end of the day, he got unlucky in a sense, because he didn't get on the bloody red in the first place. So I think that Craig needs to get out of his pram, stop sucking his dummy, and get on with it.
To be honest, this is not even a hard cut, so I don't know why he's making such an issue.
No, he's gone for the stitch. Well, that's not a bad shot.
Yeah, but, I mean, either way, why is he screaming the arse down about that? I mean, everybody gets to run over a ball over a case of 19 frames. It's going to even itself out, so why is he bigger?
But he's always done it, John. I don't know what it is. Maybe he's just his upbringing or whatever, because his composure is total pants. Well,
do you reckon he's still angry at his teeth?
Well, he might be angry about his teeth or about his hair.
I mean,
if you're ginger, you're ginger, and then you go bald, what's all that about?
Yeah, but I think he's done well to join our race. Coming from beavers and only swimming, to come from beavers and then to do what he has done in the pool league.
I've got to be careful what I say here, because at the end of that, I go up, I take my mum up to Dex, and he works up there, and they do a lovely roast dinner on a Sunday.
For a fiver.
No, it's a 7.95 actually.
$7.95 now.
I think it is. Well, during the week it might be, but at the end of the day, you know, it's a very nice dinner. Yeah, well, Andy, you can see Andy's response to it in his face, his mannerisms. He's not happy whatsoever. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've got a match on here because now it's turned out it's 3-3.
Say ladies, there's no bitches watching this.
Well, there is. There's lovely Nettie that's watching it. There's Wendy Lady that's watching it.
No one's watching it on the YouTube. They're too busy doing the cleaning and the cooking.
But when they do watch it, they can watch it whenever they want, John. They don't have to watch it tonight.
Not unless their man tells them that they're allowed to watch it.
Well, you know that. You've got to be careful here, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a bit of a sexist person here in the commentary box.
And she's not going to get away with it because we're not sexist whatsoever. Ladies and gentlemen, we have got Linford Christie in the commentary box.
Oh, how's that not going?
Hey, look at that. Now, if Andy snaps his leg, bloody well does whatever because he's got lucky there. Well, at the moment, we've got on table three, we've got Cole Stratton and Ian Garrett. Ian Garrett is 5-3. And then we've got Mark Cofer and Jamie Disney on table one. And that is Mark Cofer is 4-1 up. But on the main table here tonight, on table four, we've got a game on here actually, because I think that basically they're going to have to start using their B games, and because like their clearances, the first game it was a one visit pull, but at this moment in time it's gone a bit bandy for both of the players, and I think it's going to start ending up as a slow game, and they're going to start playing the B games. And on this table, at table four, it's 3-3. And game on.
A little bit unlucky there, he might.
Well, I don't know whether that was a good shot or not, because he had room for error on that shot, didn't he? He's a negative player.
Yeah, but it's not even the run of the ball. I mean, everybody plays cannons, they don't always work out. When you have a negative frame of mind, it ends up going bad for you.
Yeah, but this is the problem that he's had in his short career.
He realised that Andy used to teach him, tutor him.
That was a great shot.
I'll tell you what, right, Nettie, you're right. Yeah, a few years ago now. But I think I had a chat with Andy Cross about that a few years ago now. And basically, he could teach him the ropes, but it was it's Craig's mannerisms that literally gets him into trouble, because he is quality. He is a quality player.
That's but one thing that he can only teach himself. No one else can do that.
Composure. Yeah. And that is what it's all about. We all play shit shots, but we've got to get over them, you know? And Andy, you watch Andy's composure, it's completely different to Craig's. And really, honestly, Andy Cross has let Craig Smithers off the hook in the early games of this match, because Andy Cross could have been quite easily, could have been 4-1 up at one stage, and now it's 3-3. So but Craig Smithers is still whinging about it. Well, I don't like to run players down and that lot, because they are quality players. They're a lot better players than what I would ever be. But at the end of the day,
I'm glad you said you.
He's got to learn composure. Well, most probably we've got quite a nice historic event here as well, actually, because like we've had some good snooker players in Planet Thanet over the years, and I was watching John Miles play snooker, and the way he strokes the ball in is just amazing. It really is. What a fantastic cue action. It's just a shame that he's wasted it on kebabs, you know.
That is true, mate. I've wasted it on kebabs.
I remember a few years ago when John came into the odds, and you see people come and you see people go, but when John came and you see him stroke the balls in on a snooker table, it's just amazing, absolutely amazing cue action and eye coordination.
This could be 4-3. This looks like 4-3. Hold the phone, because Andy's about to go behind.
Yeah, it looks, as long as you don't get too straight on this ball over the top pocket, I suppose it don't really matter whether he is too straight.
I'm not
but I think
sure
that's
how that went in, because he actually hit the cushion just after the ball.
I think he wanted to hit it thick, John, because so he didn't leave himself too straight on that ball. But he's going to try stunning this in and hitting it quite hard. Well, he ended up screwing it.
This is 4-3.
All he's got to do is just tap this in and the black in the opposite middle pocket. Well, there you go. Well, now Andy Cross is now starting to think, well...
The thing is, sorry about him, but if Craig does win this, he's going to be fucking unbearable.
Well, yeah, you're not wrong there.
The chances are, if he does win this match, he will end up getting murdered, probably, by me.
Well, we'd have to lay odds on that, John, whether Craig Smithers is going to be assassinated this year or Donald Trump.
I'll take the double.
I think the odds are going to be... most probably
a 10 on shot. Yeah. At least one of them getting going.
Yeah.
I said that was a big turning point. That 4-1 to go into 3-2.
Joe just wants to come in and fucking brag about what he said a few frames ago.
I do. Yes, I do.
Toby.
Yeah, but there is always there's always purple patches into a game where like some players they lose composure, and then they start coming back, and
if Andy gets in this red next to
Andy's been in these positions in his professional career.
I just want to say that this is for all.
What I'd also like to say is it's a bit of a travesty. Andy has still not got the fucking beers in.
Well,
it's
I'm sure
bit,
that he'll
awkward.
Yeah, but if you've got the beers in, then I'm sure that he'd give you the money as long as you've got the receipt.
just a little nudge on this.
A little business expense.
Just a little nudge. It's for all.
There's a bit of a common joke there because obviously Andy Cross is an accountant, so he's very careful with money.
The fucking moody one.
The tight-ass fucker.
He's a yid.
I heard it was Jimmy Carr's.
That's a lovely shot.
He
kissed that beautiful. It was the perfect pace.
Right, when you've got your tongue out of his arse, I did just tell you it was 4-0 a minute ago.
John, there's no need
just wants to brag about what he said a minute ago.
Yeah, at least I'm saying it a minute ago, not fucking 24 hours ago.
Oh, he didn't want the kiss on the yellow, but he's all right. He's all right. All he's got to do is just...
He's going to struggle not to get on a red there, really.
All he's got to do is just stun this one in the bottom pocket, the bottom right-hand side. He'll have the one in the one in the left middle, and then the roll in the black. Absolutely perfect. Yeah, it's nice stand in the top right, the bottom right hand pocket.
He really needed a sharp
yes, he does. Right. Yes, he did. Yeah.
Good responses.
Yeah, yeah. I think this is where the turning point will come, because we, you know, you cannot play a decent pool throughout a whole match. There's always some games that you'll always fall short on. Well, that's a nice clearance, Andy, and now we're back on. We're back to four all.
Gone to hold each other's beer.
On table three with Carl Stratton and Ian Garrett. Ian Garrett has just pulled back a frame. So now it's 6-4 to Carl Stratton. And Mark Cofer and Jamie Disney. Mark Cofer is 5-1 up. Jamie Disney is on a clearance at the moment, but whether he get this clearance.
Mark Griffiths, obviously Jamie and Mark had a couple of altercations within the Facebook page, and I think Mark called for a lot of winners for his mate.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, they've got a bit of a grievance then, Mark Griffiths and Jamie?
Yeah,
and Jamie Disney?
Yeah, they had a little fallout. I think Jamie said he was going to knock his teeth out. But and then he found out that obviously Mark Griffiths was gay and he didn't want to touch him after that, just in case he had AIDS. Fair enough.
Oh, I never knew Mark Griffiths was gay.
It's common knowledge. Did you know
that? No, I did not know that. No.
Really?
100% I did not know that.
Yeah.
But being that I'm a person that believes in like equal opportunities and all that lot, then who gives a fuck?
Yeah, but would you want to bend over in front of him, though? You know that.
Well, no, because I'm not gay, John.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, no, I meant for your ball shot, Pete. You're on about equal rights and you fucking saying stuff like that. Horrible cunt you are. Are you off, Spud?
Oh, Matt Hughes is off home now. He's off to work. Bless you.
Matt Wumble Hughes is walking out of the establishment. I would like to say that next year he's going to be participating in this event. We thank you very much for your £120. Yeah. Please come next year.
Yes. Thank you. Testicle, see you again.
Might buy you a new bollock. Yeah, he needs one.
We're going to have a little theme tune next year. Everyone have to have a theme tune, like what they're doing the darts. And obviously Matt will be the Wombles of Wimbledon because he's only got one ball.
Yep.
But that'll be the first one. I don't know what John's one will be.
My nickname used to be Baloo the Bear, so I suppose it'd have to be Jungle Book.
I don't think you'd be a king of the swingers, John.
He's non-stop screaming, I'm telling you. He's such an annoyance. He's ploughed into balls and he just expects to get on something and he's fuming that he's not. He's tilting.
Yeah, but he's only got himself to blame, and then he just goes down on one. Just, you know, I don't know. I cannot understand it. I really can't.
He's tilting himself. I don't know why he's doing.
I mean, this. I think this gentleman. Yeah, it's four all. Yeah. We're just going to ask Ace, which is the fat controller over there, which if we can get him to mind you, I don't know if he can count the four.
Well, Craig just shouted over to the commentary box. Oof. He can't carry on as if it's bad luck. He's not really getting bad luck. He's careering into balls. If you land on something, you land on it. If you don't, you don't. He's playing it hard.
He hasn't had bad luck. They've both had their equal opportunities, and they've both had their equal amount of mistakes. But the trouble is, well, give up. Just give up. Yeah. Well, I see. I don't.
Craig's bleating. I don't even know where it is.
See, now the thing is if he says like, "I may as well give up," then. Just concede. Just throw the towel in like Ronnie O'Sullivan did with Peter Redmond. Just fucking throw the towel in. Because it's not worth bleating about it. I really.
He's not even getting that bad a run.
No, he's not.
I think he just expects to land on the ball every time when you smash it about. Like, he's a good player.
Yes, he is a good player. He's a very good player, yeah. But I cannot understand his attitude. I really can't. Because the only person that he's putting off is himself. Especially someone with Andy Cross, because Andy Cross has been there, done it. It ain't going to fucking affect him. It's all he's going to do is gee him on. And here he goes. Another clearance now. What's that, a six ball? So with the black, 7-ball clearance. Yep. Be a 7-ball clearance. So that's 2 frames on the bounce. So yeah, to be honest with you, it does affect me in my game when someone plays like this.
He's getting such a bad run. He's over in the corner screaming the house down.
Yeah.
I don't know if anybody else is watching this and thinking, what the fuck? But, like, he's starting to frustrate me. He's bleating when he's not getting a bad run. He's had a little bit of bad run and he's had a little bit of bad run.
Like, but for what I've seen, obviously I haven't watched this TV as much as what you've done, but at the end of the day, I cannot see that he has had any more bad run than Andy Cross. I can't see it. So just get on with it. Just play the fucking game.
Anyway, 5-4.
And I'm sure that my microphone's not working. 1-2, 1-2.
Ah, hello. Fucking Pete, he hasn't made it into the 21st century
I've
yet.
I've been watching
him.
This up here.
Are you Toby? That's nothing to do with it.
No, obviously not. What the fuck has that got to do with it up there then? That's a very good called gizmo down here, isn't it?
Cheers, mate.
Anyway, I'll be off to the bar shortly because I'm going to have another beer. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Andy Cross has just pulled another one back, which to be fair, the clearance that he had there, you had Craig Smithers that was going on one big time. Obviously, that would have affected the opponent because obviously they're talking on the shot and all that lot. But obviously, with Andy Cross, he's seen it, done it. He cleared up. He's 5-4 up. And if he carries on, he's going to win this because obviously Craig has lost it at this moment in time. And Andy Cross will thrive on this.
Dry break.
Absolutely thrive on it. If this goes bandy, Craig Smithers will be on the way home.
Commentator. Uh-huh. Cheers, mate. Let go to Vicky and say, can I have a jug out? I'd find out a Joe's jug line. There you go. Can I have it in that glass, darling?
I wouldn't mind her jugs.
No. I gave a little bit of friendly advice to Craig there. Because he, you know, he's sitting there beating himself up. And we'd all like to see a really good final, which is at the moment. But I did say to him that you're screaming and you're putting yourself off. You haven't had that bad of a run of the ball. We're all seeing it. It means a lot, and that's why you feel like you're getting a bad run, but you're not. Everybody that's watching a game has seen it. It's not that bad. He's not getting that much of a bad run at all, is he?
No, he's not at all. No.
But you can understand the frustration. But he just needs needs to keep his head up. Otherwise, if he loses it and Andy goes too far in front, it'll be over. Stratton's on the hill.
Joe Cunningham has just come back. He's 7-4.
Carl Stratton is on the hill in the plate.
So he's it's the last frame. What is it? 1st to 8, isn't it? No. John, what was it? Is it the 1st to 7?
1st to 8.
So, so Carl is
Pete bless him, he's a bit old.
He doesn't understand what on the hill means.
On the hill? What does on the hill mean?
It means you need one more, you toe.
Well, there's just no fucking common sense to that whatsoever.
Sorry, that's a Sky Sports commentator.
He's got one more frame to play. Obviously,
no,
if he wins it.
To play.
Obviously, if he wins
that's
it.
That's what they say is on the hill. Cheers, guys. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ant. About time you got a minute, Toby. We all want that's a good shot by Craig. We all want to see a good final where this looks like it could go 5-0 if he
this
plays.
This is quite a big shot though, isn't it, John? Because he's got to try to get position on that and then try to screw back from that red to go in between the two ones
in the
middle
really
bag.
He should really spin it around with a lot of left-hand side just to flick it round, leave it on the red into the top pocket, top left-hand pocket. And it
mind you, I suppose he can...
Where he's got his hand now is where he wants to be. He just wants to stun it down for the black after that, so this should be 5-0.
So he could pot his yellow in the middle bag, really, and that would be perfect position. Oh, he's only gone run wild.
Yeah.
Now Craig is literally going to rock the boat here. He is going to go mad. Yeah, and he's just smashed his cue on the floor.
See, the thing is, he potted it too cleanly. He wanted to put that into the right-hand side pocket of the pocket.
Yeah, but he put a lot of running on that, didn't he?
Yeah, but he needed to pot it into the right-hand side of the pocket so that the running side would swing wider. That's what he wanted to do. But he potted it too good.
But then why put so much running on it?
Well, because he wants to get out to the middle of the table. But at the end of the day, he potted it too cleanly.
Yeah, I can understand your point where to get the cue ball to the middle of the table, but why? Because he would have had a straight shot. Now we've got Jamie going on one now.
Yeah,
Jamie Disney is now rattled. He's just conceded another frame. So that'd be 6-2 to Kofa. It's all going on. It's all going on.
Disney's getting the right up.
Yeah. I tell you, I cannot understand people why they play the game. It's only a game. You know, you've got the banging of cues. I'll tell you what, they must have had a terrible upbringing.
Yeah, you pointed it too cleanly, didn't you? You actually needed to point it to the right-hand side of the pocket, yeah. I did tell Pete that, but he didn't know, bless him. He doesn't get the game, really. But, yeah. It's just confirmed by Craig that he needed to put it into the right-hand side. It wouldn't have mattered how much side he got it on. If he got it into the right-hand side of the pocket, then it would have swung much wider. He wouldn't have hit the knuckle, and he wouldn't have stayed where he stayed.
But what we're doing here is we're looking at a position where he didn't need to put that much running side on a ball, did he?
Well, in order for him to have an easy shot to stun down for the black, he needed
but he
to
didn't end up with an easy shot.
No, because he played a bad shot.
Exactly. Right? But if he'd have played a dot-to-dot position shot...
Which was playing it into the right-hand side of the pocket.
No, but he's running side, John.
Yeah,
but it didn't work.
He needed to play into the right-hand side of the pocket with running side. Where's it gone here?
Wow.
This is going to be snooker.
Yes, it's going to be snooker all day long. Now, whether he's going to try to snooker in behind the black, or whether he's just going to bring that yellow off the
strap,
off the right hand top cushion, and stitch him. Now, I do believe that. I think that he will just play the he'll just tuck him up behind the.
Yellow,
but obviously he's got
to
make
like
the cush.
Congratulate my friend Carl Stratton on winning the plate.
This would be quite interesting. Well, it looks like old Cole's just won the Challenge Cup.
Champion of the plates, Cole Stratton, everybody.
He has been playing well lately, and he's been on it, and he's just beat Ian Garrett by 8-4. Yeah, well, now you see, he did decide to play the snooker behind the black.
I
weren't sure whether he was going to play the snooker behind the black or behind the yellow, but he decided on doing the snooker behind the black because he's...
Well, that's it.
Jamie has just now broke his cue. He has just smashed his cue and it's in splinters. I'll tell you what, that Gorilla Glue is good, but it ain't going to fucking work on that cue. I'll tell you that now.
He snapped his cue.
He's not just snapped his cue, he's obliterated it. It is total fucking obliterated.
I don't think he's going to be playing with that anymore.
I'm just like, it means a lot to people, but even his dad is shaking his head.
I mean, it's not the cue's fault. But anyway, it's another one to go in the history books, but that was just fucking like unbelievable.
Well, I hope that's caught on camera.
I mean, the amount of aggression that is being caused by stupid mistakes.
I don't want it in.
Well, Andy'd be a bit cross with that, but I think Andy Cross, I'll get that, he'd be a bit cross with that, but I think he'll take this on. He'll take this on and he'll pot this. Is he going for the middle bag? He's gone for the middle bag and he's potted it.
We're just getting into a break
well
here.
Done.
It's 6-4.
Andy Cross now.
6-4 Andy Cross. Just going into a break. We rejoin it after that. Carlos. Before he says anything, I'd just like to congratulate Carl Stratton on his 8-4 victory over Ian Gayratt in the plate. Well done, matey.
It was easy, mate, really.
It was, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I know, you did get your... I noticed you had your haircut as well. We've also been joined by the loser of the plate, Carrot. It was a good match. I didn't see it.
Easy game when every time you miss, you snooker the opponent, and every time you miss, it goes in a different pocket.
So basically, did he score you?
I think yes, if it was first to nine, I would have won the next four.
He's an absolute clown. It's a bit embarrassing, but... hopefully we can edit him out.
Yeah. Well, back in the ranch is 6-4 to Andy. And there's a bit of controversial behaviour surrounding Jamie Disney. He snapped his cue on the way out and someone's keyed his car. So he came in and tried to start on one of the organisers and got frog marched out.
I actually heard that when he snapped his cue threw out the door and keyed his own car. But
that could have very well happened. But I don't know why he's trying. Like, he's obviously upset that he lost, but he's starting on people for no reason. It's not going to end well, especially down here. What's he going to do? There's about. Well, it's just stupid.
It's embarrassing.
You would have got iron straight away if you'd have started on me, by the way, Goose. You wouldn't even finish your sentence. Come and square up to me. I'll fucking put your teeth through your face.
Rocky, live from the Crucible.
Yeah, it's just stupid, though, isn't it? He's just been an absolute berk. Be back again for more, boys. Hello, Mike. Oh, Mike. Yeah, on a beer, innit? On a beers.
FBI has just walked in.
Ask Mike if he wants to do some live commentary.
He loves his voice.
Get we'd like to welcome into the studio John Virgo.
Well, Willie, it's not a formality down to the red at the left corner.
Keith, you missed it. Keith, you missed it. Someone lost their match and snapped their cue.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, and then he went outside and tried to start on Joe because someone had keyed his car.
I heard he went outside and went on eBay for another Rory O'Sullivan Q.
I think it was an Argos special.
Well, Dennis, I'm not too sure what he's doing here. Well, Dennis, I'm not too sure what he's doing. I think he's taking a time out.
Who can hear this?
People on YouTube.
Can they? Is it a big game? Sorry, Gaze. I didn't know that. I've come in on it.
There's a victor there, look.
If it was filmed, we could have done a highlight shot of these flips.
Yeah. Fucking hell.
Well, as you can see, it's... he's got a fantastic posture as this young man.
Apparently, I flute 8 gold balls.
Well, it's always better to hit it too thin than too thick.
7 yellows, then the gold.
Look, well, and I'll tell you this much, he's currently 6-4 on the bike. Can you see him getting back into it?
That was not easy.
Mike, should be a clearance from here, yeah?
Well, John, I think it's a formality. I think if he texts the yellow, if he plays the plant from the yellow onto the other yellow.
Where's that cue ball going? Oh, you didn't go down the road.
Oh, was that when your feet used to stick to the carpet? Yeah probably back then. But
the best times, though,
we're talking 15 years ago.
Well, this should be 6-5 well, now.
This should be curtains, shouldn't it?
It's just a formality, Mike.
We used to have.
Well, I think if he plays the yellow down
now
to the bottom pocket.
Big teeth and a bald nut. Look at
well, he's not.
That
I think
shiny
he's.
Head.
I think
wow,
he's taking it into the centre. Right, he's played that inch perfect. He's the right side of the yellow.
To be honest, he's caused nothing but trouble. He's not in it next year anyway.
Let's put him in a sock and just go windmilling.
Well, if he plays it with a bit of screw, where's the cue ball going? Where's it going? Well, that is hamper queuing, Willie. this is not easy.
What's your name? What's your name?
John Virgo.
John, yeah.
Well, I was just thinking, John, like, when he gets down to the table, what great beautiful hair he's got, this young lad.
Do you know
look
what, Stephen?
Look at that hair.
Stephen, you're
absolutely
right, Stephen.
Beautiful. Lovely ginger colour.
Well, I don't think he quite believes what's happened there, Stephen. Well, he's under hit it. Please. Go on, Clint, go and get the table out. Right. This is a fine cut into corner here. It's not there. Oh, it's dropped.
Wow, would you believe it, Michael? Would you believe it?
Well, Willie's got the crowd looking at him now. Right. I'm not quite sure what he's going to do here, Stephen. But, you know. Just needs to regroup. Needs to think about his next shot. As he charts the cue, he's probably going to walk round the table to see what his choices are here.
What would you do, John, on the trick shot?
Well, what would you do, Stephen?
Well, I think he's got to try and jack the cue up to play the double.
Not quite sure what he's going for here, will he?
He's played the treble.
It's there. What a pop by the young man.
That is an incredible shot.
That is absolutely fantastic. What a pot there. Right. That's for the mid-session interval.
Good day, John.
Hey, you're live. You're live. He loves
that. What a fucking treble that was.
Yeah, to be honest, it's got to be up there, isn't it? Playing a jacked-up treble like that. When he's 6'4 up to move up to 7'4 now, that is. It should have been 6'5, to be honest, and he's right back.
It's in the top 10 shots, but obviously I've been playing in the plate and I've seen a lot better.
Man! You just missed the absolute shot of the tournament.
This geezer, Ian Gayrat, is bitter. Bow selector, Garrett.
Yeah.
There is no rewind.
Yeah, you fucking Toby.
You're blinking awful at Paul.
Anyway, back at the watch, I think that's 7-4. 7-4 and this is a dish. This is a dish.
He's amongst them.
I think the scoreboard's got stuck behind. It says 6, but he is actually 7-4 up now. And with this looking to be a dish, we could be looking at a 4-frame deficit, and he could be 4 up with 6 to play.
I was 4 up in my match, and I was playing a monkey as well.
He just wanted to say it every 5 minutes. No. My mate Mike.
Hello.
Where's that cue ball going?
Where's that cue ball, Willie?
Well, I just want to say I called it a minute ago, but it's definitely going to be 8-4 now. Can you see Craig coming back from this?
It's going to be hard, Willie. It's going to be hard.
Willie? Have I got my Willie out?
Willie Fawn.
Fucking cheeky bastard.
I can see your crotch from here.
Well, he's just going to stun this out. But I'll tell you this, I've played a couple of pots up into this corner pocket, and if it doesn't go clean in, it's going to stick in the pocket. It's like a goalkeeper there, so he's got to play it with a little bit of pace to get it out. So this is miserable.
Just got to see it. Happened here. Yep, it's the Man City goalkeeper that was in. The Man City goalkeeper was in that pocket. He's gone straight through it.
It's tilted.
It's like a Churchill dog, wobbly head. Like to say that Cookie's sneakers in the corner are looking rather good. There they are, Cookie's sneakers, they're looking rather buff. I'm sorry, I'm just about to have a conversation with the runner-up of the plate final. Pretty embarrassing that he made it that far, but Must have had an easy round.
Do Well, I've been left on my own in the commentary box because Carl's busy collecting his winnings. It's like I say that him and Garrett had already actually split the winnings. It's just for pride. And Carl has the bragging rights, especially winning 8-4. It's a very one-sided, well, very one-sided score, really. But as we're closing in on this match, it has been, well, it's been exciting, but at the end of the day, Andy's done what he needs to do. And a couple of times, Craig's lost his head. But that shot by Andy, that treble that he played, the jacked up treble, that's such a good shot. We're joined in the commentary box by Pete the Pedo Curtis.
Well, that's not fair, because that's not been proven, John.
Yeah, gets his name from touching.
Yeah, you can't start calling me Rolf Harris, guess what it is, yet.
Not yet. See, yet kind of implies that it is true, though, Pete.
Well, no, because...
No, it does.
No, because...
When you say yet, that's leaving it open.
No,
to
but
you.
It's
I
not.
Haven't actually been
I have yet. Never, I have never been prosecuted to be a paedophile.
That's because you've never been brought to trial yet.
That's no because most probably they all enjoyed it.
No, they're all under your patio, that's why. Good shot by Craig.
Anyway, so...
Craig has been complaining yet again a lot. And he played a screw back and it just stopped in time, didn't go behind the black, to which part Craig was screaming, so that if that was me, it'd have gone behind it.
Oh, really? Oh, look at that. Look.
All that means is that he didn't play the bad shot.
Exactly. He just played a bad shot then. Did you see that lovely triple?
Yeah, it was a shot of tournament, I think.
It was. It was. It was quality, wasn't it? Because there was a pinpoint position shot. You know, obviously the position was bad, you know, but to come out with some shot like that without hitting the cue ball twice as well, because the cue ball screwed back beautiful. So it wasn't a push shot in either way, you know, it was a very good shot. Unbelievable. And that is the reason why you've got to say it, he is the number one player.
Yeah, 8-4 up, it looks like his curtains. Doesn't like his curtains.
But why would you say the reason is? I think there's only one reason, and that's these Craig's mentality.
Wobbly head, yeah. And he has composed himself a bit now, but earlier on he was getting down and just hitting the shot straight away.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, if you're playing Andy Cross, you've got to be level-headed. You know, it's not even worth trying to be at the races and trying to clear up and try to pot him out of, you know, get yourself out of trouble, because it ain't going to happen.
Well, I did do that.
Yeah, but you're not there.
No, but I'm the only person to beat him this year, and that is exactly what I've done.
Yeah, well, there you have it. So it'd have been nice to have seen that one, John.
Yeah, even Andy said it'd have been nice to see that final, but I mean, it hasn't worked out.
What final was that?
Me versus Andy.
What, the final or in the league?
No, what, I beat him in the league.
In the league, beat him in the league. That was the one, yeah?
Yeah.
It went on table one, so it's not on YouTube anyway. No one can watch it.
No, I don't think it was on.
No. Oh, that's a shame.
But to be honest, we both didn't play very well that game. I just played slightly better.
Well, I must admit, that's my claim to fame as well, because I did beat him in the Thanet Elite. I can't remember what the score was now, but...
No, you beat him off in the toilet. It doesn't count, Pete.
No,
he
I didn't
told
do
you
that.
He was 12
'cause,
when you got
no, because
there
he's
go.
Not, because he's about the same age as me, 54.
Both. Both facts are an absolute million.
Do apologise for the rustling there. It was Joe Cunningham was playing with John's bra.
But I was waiting for him because that's what I was
which obviously he wears one now because he is getting quite heavy, or he has always been heavy, but he's okay, getting heavier.
Do it, John, and then just throw him down the stairs.
Well, this looks like 9-4.
Well, it's nice to see Calvin Kleiner doing well as well, because
still in the market.
Yeah.
They're a bit out of your price range, Pete, at the moment.
No, I don't wear Calvin Kleins, no. I wear Penguin.
I thought you still wear white front.
Because I like the beak at the front. Well, here we go. Here it is.
This isn't easy. He's got, I think.
Yeah, maybe.
He's either got to roll this in dead weight or stun it in off the cushion. This is not a gimmick.
Yeah, stun it off the side cush.
Under a bit of pressure as well.
Mm.
But he's 4 frames in front, so.
But he's got a big area. If he stuns off that side cushion, he has got a big area to get into. Oh, is he played? He ain't played it hard enough.
No, it's hard enough.
That was a shame because.
It is hard enough.
Oh, from this angle, I can't really see it. I don't know how you can see it from this angle because it's the same fucking angle.
Because I'm not an idiot.
Well, I don't like to be called an idiot.
Factually, it is correct. Tell me I'm wrong, Pete. All jokes aside, it's the Ramsgate George Clooney.
Oh, I've put my glasses on now, and yes, I can see the ball now.
It is the Ramsgate George Clooney.
See, he's like
the father I never
but
wanted.
He's looking. See, now he cannot see that.
I think you actually might be right there.
Yeah, you fucking wanker. Do you know you're full of shit? You are. You're so much fucking like. Yes, you saying that he could fucking fully see that. Oh, do you know, I should have put a bet on that. Darren, I should have put a bet on that.
I don't know if you noticed, but he had to go and try and say Darren because no one's actually listening to what he was saying.
Well, you turned your head because basically you was completely in the wrong. So therefore, you... Do you know, I think I'm about to get my vaporizer out of my pocket and that lot and smoke this place out.
Fucking 6 mil out. Well, this is
Cray's going to win this.
This is A5 now. This could be a turning point.
See, all it needs is a committed shot to stun that onto the side cushion and bring that cue ball off. He had a big area to aim for and he missed it.
They are both capable of a win here and there, but I don't think Cray's going to do it this round. The only shot now is the red to the black that he can muck up. I don't think he's going to muck that up. He's just playing into the middle perhaps.
See, why did he hit that so slow? Why use so much?
Well, it was a deceleration. That's why.
A margin for error.
You could see another cue slap here. I know, went in, it's fine.
Yeah. It would have been a cue. That would have been a cue slap.
I do make reference to another cue snap. Where I don't know if you was joining us earlier, you might actually see on the other match that Jamie Disney, after losing to Mark Colfer 7-2, snapped his cue into 3 bits.
Well, I think it was more than 3, John. He fucking obliterated that cue.
Yeah,
that cue is irreparable, man.
Well, I don't know.
Not even his dad could repair that fucking cue,
well,
and he's a
Darren
master.
It
was his dad's cue. It was his dad's cue. Jamie Disney was playing with his dad's cue because obviously he ain't got a cue because he broke the fucking last one. And then he's absolutely obliterated his dad's cue. Now, what is all that about?
The bloke that comes down here, Vince, he plays poker, I know his wife as well. He said he's known him for a short period of time. We'll let that comment go. I've known him. He said he's known him for a short period of time, and that's the second cue he snaps.
Well, only 2? Is that it?
Well, he's known him a short period of time.
Yeah, well, that'd be about right. What, 2 weeks?
Could be. Could have done days with Jamie.
Yeah.
He's actually quite a good player when he gets his temper.
Yeah, he is. Yeah, yeah. I played him. He beat me in the Elite a few seasons back. But once again, you know. I beat myself, really.
But the silliness with him starting...
Not literally.
...when there's about 50 of his mates in here is stupid.
Well, there's another story to that as well, isn't it? Because at the end of the day, you know, you don't start on someone.
So, I'd just like to say that the the prize for the well-dressed person walking through the odds snook hall tonight goes to a young Sean Mason, who is wearing his lovely sneakers, and he hasn't deferred, and he's stuck with his puffer jacket since he's been in the establishment. Looks like might even be a Penguin puffer jacket. Is it Penguin, Pete?
I'm not sure.
It's a lovely colour.
I don't think it's got Penguin written on the top.
It's
is
a
it?
Lovely colour, but he is the most well-dressed gentleman here tonight.
And here he comes in the commentary box. Sean Mason. Sean, is that a Penguin jacket?
It's a warm one.
What does it say?
Warm one. Yeah.
We're not quite sure who that is, but yeah. He's been wearing it all night, and he's committed to wearing it.
Well,
he has been voted tonight's most well-dressed person. The most well-dressed person.
Well, we don't even
tonight,
know what's going on.
It has been voted is Sean Mason. The most well-dressed person tonight.
But who voted that then, John?
Well, it was only me and you in it, and I said it first.
Well, no, I didn't even vote. So,
hold on.
It's your decision.
There could be a redraw.
I think he just
Colonel
played
Cole,
a dead weight shot, didn't he?
Chicken wing back.
Who?
The Colonel.
Who's the Colonel?
Look, I'm fat, you know who that is. Kentucky Fried Chicken.
What, are you going for that?
No.
Fuck me. How many meals do you have a day?
I'll fucking eat you in a minute, you cunt.
Hello, we're gonna have to start calling him the fucking Pac-Man. Because he'll eat any fucker. Anything and any fucker. Oh, and there you have it.
Once again, Andy, I'm going to say it so you know, Andy's on the hill. So he needs one more for the victory. Can you see Gray coming back from
there? Andy is on the hill.
Can you see him coming back from there?
No. No.
Moment. Do you reckon he's just going to win this and wrap it up?
You know, I wouldn't even... Do you know, I would say the odds are 4-6 on.
Is that the only
John?
Odds you know, though? I just like to comment, because Pete's been in a group with us on WhatsApp, but it takes him about half an hour to type hi. He's 97. Oh, wow. That was almost an enough there.
That was a reckless break. Oh, he's got one.
Congratulations, Mark, on winning the cup. No, well, you don't need to. Kirby's been and gone, hasn't he? He came and got his money, and then he left. I'd just like to say, as Colfer walks out, that Kirby, as he walked out the door, spat on the back of Colfer, unnoticed. Either that or Colfer just melted again. When Kirby put it on him last week, he did melt then as well.
I didn't even see Kirby enter the building.
Well, yeah,
to be
he's
fair.
Fucking sloped in like Dennis. Dennis is a local odds establishment.
Yeah. Dennis is tuner and fucked off. Sneaky bastard.
Licked his paws on the way out of Toby.
Yeah. Anyway, you can't beat a decent Sean Kirby with a stick, with a fucking big stick. In fact, even with any fucking thing you want.
This was happening in the semis. The white ball is nowhere near where he's just tried to hit it, but yet he tried to pot it. It's not the greatest shot, that.
Well, he's still got game on here, isn't he? He's going to play this one. It's a bit of a dodgy shot though, isn't it? Because he's come out well there. He's played that well. You know, the only bad ball he's got is that that red near the middle bag, isn't it?
We're all rooting for 9-9, so it gets very, very tense.
Well, to be fair, I'm not. Because. Oh no! That obviously that red pass is in the middle because he's just playing that. So So once again, the camera angle that we have, we don't have Hawkeye.
What? No. I mean, I can see it goes.
Yeah, but you said that in the last shot, and it was fucking nowhere near. See, now he won't be happy with that.
No, it's not a good
not
shot.
At all.
Carl Stratton's in the background there, just saying so what now, shit shot that was.
All he's got, the choices are, he just plays this dead weight.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He plays this dead weight. And then he's got one hell of a long black.
Keith is just dying up.
Yeah.
When they're setting up, can you just put it in front of the camera so that
I told you he obliterated it. Look at the fucking state of that. But anyway, here we go for the long black to make it 7-9-6. Oh,
it's dropped.
There was only one way that was going.
Hey, we just got to put it on the camera very quickly.
The Einstein's theory came in there where gravity just
to the table.
Brought that
close
ball down.
And that's Jamie Disney's cue right there, bless
which
him.
Which has made that
he's
now.
He's left it behind. I don't know what he's doing with that. Well,
it's like Wolverine's arm.
I'll tell you what, I'm not using my Gorilla glue on that fucking cue.
Well, we've been joined in the commentary box by the well-dressed man again. Here he is. Always smiling as well, always happy.
Who, me?
No, not you, you old cunt. Sean Mason. I think he's a secret millionaire. He's waiting to just give me my cheque, but he hasn't.
Wait a minute. Call me an old cunt. He's the same age as me.
He's not the same age as you.
He is. He is fucking 58.
He's not even... He's early 40s at best.
The reason why he looks so good is because you look fucking shit. Every time
you look
in the mirror.
I just put him next to you.
You look in the mirror 24/7. You look like a fucking pile of dog shit. And of course, when anyone walks through the fucking door, you think, oh, I like him. It's quite simple, isn't it?
I just thought.
Anyway, let's not go down
that
road.
Pete's meds have slowly run out. I don't know if you've noticed, but he started slurring slowly throughout the night.
Well, fucking slurring. Yeah. But anyway.
He was allowed out tonight anyway.
Shall we just concentrate on this game? Because this is a very important match here, and it's a very important game.
He's trying
now
to deflect from
think,
the way that I'm slowly starting
think,
to get him.
No, not at all, John. Not at all. You're a fat fucker. There's no way of getting out of it. And you really must start thinking about being an anorexic, because it might do you favours. It might take you a few years or a few decades, but you'll get there. But let's concentrate on the game, not on your figure. Or Sean's, as a matter of fact, because you was checking him out all night.
What,
you pervert.
Well, I can't help it. He's a good looking fella. What is it?
They've just taped Carl Disney's cue together, which obviously Carl Disney weren't playing tonight. It was Jamie Disney that was playing with fucking his dad's cue, and he obliterated it into fucking 4 to 5 pieces. Well, I can't believe it. He used to be in the army, for Christ's sake.
Jesus.
You just imagine him.
Pete's
talking
about national service.
Yeah,
in
the fucking inner art with a temper tantrum. Crikey, you shoot every fucking raghead.
Taxi for Pete. You get half price being an OAP. You fucking worm food.
Yeah. Yeah. At least I'm doing something about my weight problem.
I don't need to. I sweat it all off running around that.
Yeah, I bet you fucking do.
You can't lose weight if all you're doing is racking them up all the time.
I bet that it's fucking rinsing off you. Just walking around that pool table must bring you out into a sweat.
It is when I iron your missus out, mate.
If you went on a diet, you needed a fucking iron to fucking get that skin
in
order.
Oi, stop muttering and stuttering and liven yourself up.
I've always stuttered. That is my problem in life.
No more beers for you. He's had half a shandy. The geezer's fallen on the floor.
Anyway, let's just talk about...
At least Spud's not here. No swinging for him, all right?
Hold on. Let's just talk about this game. Now, how is it going?
No, fuck the game. Let's insult each other. He's just lifted up his armpit, to which it smells worse than Wendy on a fucking Friday night.
No. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll edit that out because that's not the case.
I just like to say, frame and match, Andy Cross.
And that is a very tight there, isn't it? But he's fucking like, he's played that well, hasn't he? He played that well. To be fair, it's deserved. It is absolutely deserved. I think that
you're not
Craig
a dog,
Smithers,
are you, Gary?
Was not.
Pull your tongue
was
out of
not
my arse.
At the fucking races. He was not at the races.
Oh dear! He didn't just do the fist pump.
Yeah.
Even his missus is cringing in the background.
She always cringes when I'm round her. Yeah. Whenever she sees me, she cringes. Because she thinks, hello, not again. I hope you had a shave tonight.
Yeah, do you like my hairy ass? Well,
ladies
well
and gentlemen,
Andy Cross.
This is Peter Curtis signing off now because basically
no one gives a fuck.
John's
just put your
really
mic down and
fucking
fuck off,
pissing
you
me off.
Go on.
The fucking
you know where the door
fat
is.
Cunt.
Sunshine bus comes in a minute. Off your fucking pop. A quick interview with a runner-up here, Craig. Hey, how'd you feel, bud? Obviously, you played well tonight. It wasn't quite enough tonight. How are you feeling about it?
A bit better than I was last time I played him in the final. I think early on, I missed a couple of chances. I had a little couple of little cannons that I missed, I think, and he just punished me every time, and he deserved to win. I don't know.
He's a fucker, isn't he?
Prick.
He's a prick.
An absolute twat, but yeah, he picked me off, and I was trying to be a bit more forceful rather than going Michelle, because sometimes against him you can go the other way and play a bit too negative, start rolling balls, and I thought, fuck this, I'm going to have a go, and if I go out, I'm going to go out queuing.
Like, well, you had your chances, Yeah. What do you think of the treble, the jacked up treble?
I just saying to him about it, killed me.
Yeah.
Because I thought I potted the yellow for one, and then he fucked up, and I thought, I'm back in here, 7-6 that was for, and then he pulled out the treble, and that was it.
Yeah.
That was the killer.
Yeah, he played well. Well, unlucky, buddy.
Cheers, mate.
Still good.
Yeah, I'm happy.
Quick word with the winner, Mr. Andy Cross, if he can come over.
Bloody another star.
Here he is.
John, you're not going to say beers are on me, are you?
Fucking hell, look at him. Idiots.
You're not going to say beers are on me, are you?
Well, the beers are on you.
Yeah. Have I got to get another jug
well
in,
played,
have
well played,
I?
Mate.
Thank you, mate.
Well
cheers,
played.
Mate.
We were just talking about your treble, probably being one of the turning points.
I'll be honest with you. From when I was 4-3 down, I ran 3 on a bounce to go 6-4 up. I didn't want the break to come.
No.
I wanted to carry on and just start.
The killer.
Yeah, he's like, yeah, I'm going to milk it for all I can for the chicken curry, and I'm like, no, you don't want to be doing that.
Yeah.
But no, I came back and I should have lost that frame after.
Yeah, there was a.
And
kind of
I played a bad shot. I think he cleared, and then he's. And I didn't expect him to rattle that yellow. He's rattled the yellow, left me a clearance, but I've messed it up. And
yeah, don't show on camera.
Yeah,
cheers.
Sorry, apologise.
Cunt.
Yeah. And left me that treble, and I played it perfect. It's, you know,
played
what
well,
can you do? I played well. I did play well today.
How
I played
many,
well.
How many time champion is that now?
Just the 4, yeah.
Just the 4 in
just
a row,
the
yeah?
Just the 4. You're coming after me now, John, yeah?
I fucking am,
you are. You're going to fucking have it.
He's not
No, please. I played well. I think I did some nice clearances at crucial times in that match.
Yeah.
I should have 7-4. I've dished that to go 8-4, and it kills him, you know. And I mean, there was a few couple of other frames in that match. All right, it could have gone his way. My frames, I won, but I felt I had 2 or 3 frames that I should have won.
Yeah,
like 4-1, 5-1. That 4-1, 5-1 frames, I possibly should have won.
I mean,
I missed that black in the middle.
I said to Craig, you both had your chances, but at the end of the day, you're clinical. There's a reason you're number one.
I try. I'm always shot up every fucking. I'm shot at every single match I play. Like, and you know, it's tough. You just. Well, everyone wants to beat you.
I just
want
to have a
know?
Little shameless break to the camera saying I am the only person to beat him this year.
Okay, John Miles, you're the only person to beat me this year. Well done, mate.
Well played, mate.
Well done. Cheers, mate. Thank you. Cheers, mate. Thanks.